students. As I have observed over the past 10 years, many of the students face difficulty in performing analog electronic circuit experiments. So if you take care of certain things, it should not be very difficult to conduct experiments. Like in previous videos also I have explained that to use CRO, you have to calibrate this CRO in the beginning itself. On all the CROs, you will have one point to calibrate it, like a standard output will be there. On this CRO, there is a point where you will get 2 volt peak to peak square wave, and the frequency of the square wave is 1 kilohertz. So to calibrate this, connect your CRO probe and connect the point to this. You should be able to see this waveform. And since it is a 2 volt peak to peak, it should cover 1 division. This is a volts per division knob. Means if you want to measure the amplitude, you will be counting the divisions. So number of division and into this the knob where it is pointing, it will be our amplitude. So 2 volt peak to peak, I have kept it for 2 volt, and it should cover 1 division, means that you are having 1 volt. So as you can see, if you check the amplitude, it is approximately 1 division. There will be a knob to move the waveform up and down to position, that is along the y axis, can move this waveform. Then there will be this knob to calibrate, that is you can vary the amplitude. As you can see, you can make it small and make it you can change according to your needs. So there will be one point where it will be pointed. You have to keep that in that direction only and see whether it is giving proper amplitude. So I have to calibrate this channel as well as the channel. If you want to use both the channels, calibrate both the channels. So I am calibrating second channel now. Connect this to the standard output provided on the CRO. And as you can see, it is 2 volt peak to peak. Here the volts per division is pointing to 2 volt. And if it covers 1 division, that means your amplitude is shown properly. Now frequency. So it is a 1 kilohertz frequency. Your time division will be there. A knob will be there to change the time division. So vary that. Keep this on 1 millisecond. So it should point 1 millisecond, and your 1 cycle, that is positive as well as negative, should point to should cover 1 division. From this point to this point it should cover. So here one point will be there to vary the along x axis. Vary this. If it is not covering 1 division, can vary this, and both positive and negative cycle should cover approximately 1 division. See, now this is a negative cycle and this is a positive cycle. So in 1 division we are having positive as well as negative cycle. Now this channel is calibrated for even frequency. Likewise, you calibrate both the channels. Let us check if the first channel is calibrated. Okay, so